You have probably heard countless times that you should never edit a Docker container state, or editing container state is an anti-pattern, or if you need to edit a container state, you should use volumes. And in this video, we will talk about how to use volumes. I am going to attach a volume to the Jupyter Notebook container, this one. So the notebook I will create in the container will appear on my local machine in the Docker directory, here. First of all, we have to run the container from a working directory you want to use. I use this Docker directory. We can use again the run command p888888jup, and I'm pressing tab to autocomplete the name. Enter. Okay. Copy. Paste. The work directory is empty. To use volumes, we have to use the Docker run command, but we have to use the dash v parameter. V means volume. And then I have to specify the absolute path to the directory in my local machine that should be mounted to the Docker container. And to do it, to get this absolute path, we can use pwd command. Here in the second terminal, inside my Docker directory. Let's copy it. Copy. Trailing slash, then colon. And again, after the colon, I have to specify the corresponding path that will be used inside the Docker container. Before the colon is my local directory, after the colon, the directory inside the container. And I used this path in the previous video. Home, Jovian, work. And of course, I have to run it on these ports. Doesn't matter. Just jup. Copy this command. Stop this container. Paste the command here. And after jup, I just press tab to autocomplete the name of the repo. Okay, hit enter. The work folder, and now it has coins, CSV, and the text. And if I create a new notebook with some state, save, then let's close it, let's kill the container and run it again. And it's working. My state is saved. The next video will be about how to install libraries inside the container. So see you in the next video. If you like this one, please leave a like and subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching.